So this is our 2 horsepower grinder pump. It's the Liberty Omnivore. We're running it here in a tank, a live demo. It's grinding up shop rags and diapers and underwear. But the point of this demo is that we're only running up 2 foot of lift, so it's a maximum flow, maximum amperage. This is actually the toughest case scenario right here. And we're just gonna run it and put some tough stuff through the grinder pump. Shop rags. Very little effort, chews up that shop rag. Fine slurry. Here's a piece of denim. It's got little metal studs. Got the pocket. I was chewing on that denim, right? And I shut the float off right in the middle of chewing on it. And when you shut it off, that's when all that stuff is wound up in the cutter, and that's when she's gonna jam. So that's what's left of the denim. And if you look closely, you know, you'll probably see, I'll put it through, I might find a zipper in there, and I'll actually put a zipper through there, but you'll find the metal studs, and it'll eventually eat all this, and it'll leave the metal bits behind. But the metal bits don't get sucked in and jammed the cutter, that's the whole point. Now, garbage bags, plastic bags, no problem. I'll put through this plastic bag here first. An air bubble. Pump's going right there. But this pump is self-priming, so you cannot airlock this pump. That's another neat feature of it. The impeller is very, very close to the suction inlet, so you can't airlock it. Now I'll show that. Well, I'll just show it to you now. What I could do is let the air trap an air bubble. Okay, so I just let the water out and it got air inside the volute. And it's evacuating the air and it starts pumping. It's another feature that we designed in, so it doesn't airlock. Leather glove. Anybody got any old ones they want to trade me for new ones? All the leather bits in there, and it's pretty much ate that entire leather glove. There's a chunk of leather left down in there, so it's going to chew leather. Here's an adult Depends diaper. This is the big boy with the stretchy stuff on top. This is a mop. That's what's left. The denim's still there. The leather glove's almost gone. Here's the mop. Stop it and start. All right, so I think that's enough for demonstration purposes, but let's say, you know, 2 years from now or whenever, let's say the cutter dulls a little bit. The cutter is hardened stainless steel, but if it's chewing on abrasives or sand or something, let's face it, it might dull out a little bit. If it gets dull, maybe it will jam on you one day. If it does jam, this is how you service a Liberty pump. You unplug it from the wall or just shut off the breaker. Oh. This is the disconnect system here. I just pulled it off the guide rail. It's that simple. It has this big heavy claw here and this rubber grommet that seals its seats off on there, so that's very easy. That will actually seal a two-stage pump, that simple. So if I want to service it, I'll pull it out, set it on the ground. So in the service, in the field, you put a wrench on there and pop that off. Okay, there's your quick disconnect cord feature. So this pump gives you an issue. If it's done from 3 years from date of installation, you pop the power cord out of the head of the pump, you pull out of the system, pop the power cord out, within minutes, you've serviced it, you take it back to Pump Express, over-the-counter exchange, you get a new pump, you screw that back together, put it back down the guide rail, very quick to service a pump. It's got a little keyway system in here, so you can put that back like that, and you just simply screw that back together. Easy. That's the guide rail system. Now what you want to do when you insert this pump on a guide rail system, you'll have a chain back here. You want to pull on that chain and pull up the pump like that, because what you want is that pump to sit up at an angle. That angle is the proper installation. If you drop this pump down by the handle, if you put a rope on the handle, if you set it like that, it's not sealed. So it will get blow by on the guide rail. That's not good, because the pump will be running twice as much as it should. With the chain, the way the chain is designed, when you lower it down, it will hang properly. But some guys seem to have the ability to make it go in horizontally. It should lower in properly when you lower it by the chain, but just to know that sitting up at an angle is the right installation. And that's a nice design, because it lets the diapers and all your debris get under there easier, so it will eat the material better. And that's it.